The stat was something along the lines of 47 out of 57 games, Ogre Magi has been picked or banned prior to this series. That's a whole lot of Magi.
Yeah, it is. By the way, that guy had a sign that said, "Hi, Nick," but it was just on a bit of torn off cardboard.
Hi, Nick.
He's been turning it toward the... Oh man, Nick. That was a good stare. Damn. He's been turning it toward the cameras every time possible. He must really love Nick.
Yeah, but also, if you like Nick so much, get a you know, tidy up your sign.
Why didn't
saying,
you
tidy
get
it
him
up a little
ticket?
Bit of, like, bit of word art, you know? Really put some effort into it, maybe a nice border.
Something.
Yeah, I'd like that.
Hire an artist.
Multicolored Sharpies, just mix it up.
It's like they found a box outside the venue and just, give me that. Hi, Nick. No offense, you guys are great. Don't kill me.
Or they just genuinely found it on the floor, like, I don't know who this is for, but this is mine now.
I want to hold up a sign, don't matter what it says.
Yeah.
Say hi, Nick.
Okay, maybe. We need to recap because I think it looks like we have Mirana.
Yeah, Mirana SD.
Mirana SD, the Soul Catcher obviously makes Mirana's burst potential extremely high. We've also been seeing Lunas go for this super late BKB build, obviously, because if you build BKB too early, it can be a big detriment to you early on. So if you're specific example, sure, but with the Mirana, with this like the potential to burst the Luna before he gets BKB is very high. You're very good at illusion clearing as well, which Luna will get a Manta, of course, at one point in the game. It's just a really good pick with Shadow Demon too. It's just safe, doesn't give anything away. It leaves your lanes open-ended.
I mean, the main thing about Arteezy's BKB, it wasn't that it was early, it was that he didn't really need it. Like, it was all physical damage, so it was like, what's the point? But I mean, against a team that's all magical damage, I didn't think it would be terrible to get it relatively early. You wouldn't die.
And not dying is probably a good thing.
But then you don't hit, you know? It's like, you want the combination. How come people don't get Ags Luna? Explain it to me, Fogged. Explain it to me like I'm a child.
Your other items are just better. You don't want to be dependent on your ultimate so highly. You want to be a physical damage dealer, tower pusher. If you're just relying on your ultimate so highly, not really the greatest.
It's so cool.
It does look cool. I mean, it's a great item. Oh. It's not like it's a bad item.
Bye-bye, Magi.
Yeah.
I think, banning out the Undying, the Ogre, weakening Faceless's lanes for sure, and just taking out more of their comfort heroes. Like I mentioned before, they stole the Undying, stole kind of in a way for the Undying from them before, but not going to let it happen. And, you know, they're maybe like thinking, these guys are taking our picks, you know?
Yeah.
They're taking our draft from before.
And is that something that is kind of viable and has a pretty good success rate?
Just nicking so much
basically going, hey, that worked, let's give that a whack.
Sure.
I mean, I guess if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Mm-hmm. Slacks has a new hobby.
Yeah, what is this? He's Snapchat.
Yes, he has discovered Snapchat, and there's actually a pug filter.
Get back to work.
There's a pug filter? That's actually pretty sweet.
Isn't there a Boston Major filter?
Yeah, there is.
Yes.
Yeah. There is an actual voter filter on Snapchat.
Looking at the Faceless bans, Invoker, of course, Weeha had such a stellar performance, and it lasted. It works really well with their draft as well. And okay, they take Enchantress. And the Alchemist ban, of course, you know, Shadow Demon is just the Alchemist.
That in-sync mode from Shiva, Empyrean, Flex.
Oh,
explain yourself, please.
Don't remix that. I mean, I figure it'll be...
Hi, Nick.
Maybe it'll be more effective than the Chen.
I hope so.
But we'll see.
It's different. It's a little bit different. Obviously, it strengthens your lanes more, but it's really, I mean, when you pick a Chen or an Enchantress line, you put a lot of pressure on the person who's playing it.
You should.
And instant response, I kind of said how DC likes to, you know, counterpick kind of in a way, or just like prep themselves up for the draft that they're facing. So Juggernaut, pretty hard for Enchantress to really gank. Great versus Luna at most of the stages of the game, and it gives you sustain for your push and sets you up into a tempo for your game.
I'm not sure if Nuts is the one playing the Enchantress. He's never played Enchantress in his competitive career.
Okay.
At least not according
to Dota. Now's the time. Let's stick him on Enchantress.
Hey, this is what you asked for, Ted. You said you haven't won a single game.
Go ham.
Go ham.
Yeah, but boss of the walls. They pick Centaur now, too.
Yeah, here you go.
Do you think it might be XY playing it? Check if he does.
Centaur's back.
We have Centaur in the group stages. He did pretty well, I think. In fact, I think they won, didn't they?
VP's game.
Yeah.
That was here, wasn't it?
Was it?
That was yesterday.
That was yesterday.
Was it? Fair enough. Yeah.
Well, we like that. We got the Ag Centaur and everyone just ran over walls, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right.
I'm trying to think the reasoning as to why they did it, though. At least for this game. Obviously, it gives them more like lockdown. Like, the obvious things was lockdown, heavy burst. What did they really... I guess they just wanted a heavy, beefy frontliner for the Luna. One of the only things that really come to mind for me right now.
Okay.
And just a disengage for Juggernaut.
At least we're getting to see some more heroes in play. I mean, that's Faceless and a silver lining.
Okay.
And I doubt the DC are going to have prepared for Enchantress Centaur.
That's because they generally wouldn't have to, because it's not It's good in very specific situations, and I've yet to see if this is one of those specific situations. Digital Chaos has still two picks to prepare for anything they might expect to come their way from Faceless. I mean, so far, if you look at Faceless, Fog, do you see like a specific timing they should hit? I mean, they've got the Luna, they've got the Siege, but at the same time, there's a Shadow Demon as well. What's Faceless' plan?
Wake up! Yeah, you.
I mean, they're just picking like a Luna strategy and having a frontliner, like I was kind of mentioning. They're just going for. I mean, they're just like, it's just like a safe pick. It doesn't really reveal like too much what they really want. Just decent team fight.
Yeah.
Just having like this guy in the front who can tank everything.
But Ducks, yeah.
Enchantress does enable you to be able to pick like different type of offlaners, as we've seen. Like the Enchantress goes and helps him out. That's probably more so what he'll do this game. But picking this Darkseer changes it up a little bit more, because now you don't know where you still don't really know where the Mirana could be. It's more like now it can more than likely be a mid laner. They can pick an Earth Spirit or something like that with the Darkseer or Spirit Breaker and just be emphasizing on heavily pressuring the lane that we saw before. This is a DC approach. They leave their lanes open ended so they can really change up the way that they're going to approach the game at any stage. And even if Fists, he actually even feels forced to ban out a Meepo.
Yeah. Wow. They it's lost happened. Against the Digital Chaos Meepo in 20 minutes at some point, I believe.
It's still a hero that they can pick up for sure. They can put the Mirana support. They have the Shadow Demon Mirana Roman combo, Juggernaut safe lane, Darkseer Meepo. Meepo fits pretty well into the lineup too. I mean, Meepo can fit into lots of lineups, especially if it's a last pick. It's just like one of those like, your face.
We lost. Yeah, it's one of those. Yeah.
Don't forget that was a promise actually from ex-Nova of Warriors that perhaps a Meepo will be cropping up in later games.
A promise that perhaps, maybe?
Well, but he said, I can't reveal anything, and then Slax made him explain with a facial expression, which was a smirk.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the most info I can get.
All right.
Close enough.
It's almost a promise in my mind.
So DC bans out the Tinker.
Tom. Hey,
that's
Tom.
A very individually like targeted ban at Faceless at Jabs, because that's one of his more played heroes. That's Tom and a Gurg there.
Yeah, Tom and Gurg. Shout out. Oh, that lad's getting drinking nice and early. Cheers, right. Cheers.
With a glass of champagne.
I'm not going to lie. Where's our champagne?
Yeah.
That's true.
I like this. This is a very straightforward DC lineup. It looks like kind of what you'd expect from like VP type of thing, you know, DK, Darkseer. They have a timing window push, but they also have heavy late game with the Shadow Demon Juggernaut combo. They even have great, they just have lots of setup. This gives them the lockdown that they were kind of missing with the only Mirana being like their only stun on top of Vacuum.
DC's lineup is solid.
Yeah, it feels like you guys are sold on DC's draft at this point in time, and then you're sitting there with eyebrows raised and a bit of a frown.
It depends what Faceless can pull out of the bag for their fifth pick. It's going to need to be something that we're like, like techies or something.
So this is
we
like
didn't
a drum
think about
roll.
This. This is genius.
It works. It's so good.
I just can't imagine what it might be, but
I'd love to see what if like the brainstorm you can come up with anything, Fog. Theorycraft. This final pick. Something that could be justified. This is his thinking face, by the way.
Yeah. When he's thinking, he does tilt his head back.
Yeah.
Purses his lips.
Purses his lips.
And then he waits until it's been picked and says, I thought it would be that.
Yeah, he's
no,
got nothing.
I'm
coming
not
up
sure.
empty. He's
trying to
empty.
Think of what can like really round up their lineup, because they still kind of lack physical damage. It's literally all in on the Luna for physical.
I reckon it'll be something like Nature's Prophet or something.
I don't think it'll be Nature's Prophet.
Yeah, 100%, dude.
Jabs has played Medusa. It's not banned this time, but
it was
they don't
banned
have
the first time.
Medusa could, that's actually good call. It could be a possibility that they're going for. It makes them like having a pretty greedy draft, though. They're really slow on their timings.
And then there's a lot of pressure on Enchantress getting a lot done in the early game, which I don't have a lot of confidence in at this point. But I will be happy to be proven wrong.
Mm.
And they're taking their time, though. They're almost out.
They're thinking about it.
I know Jabs has played Mag every now and then. I mean, they don't really have a melee carry core to deal with it, though. But, okay, so Sniper. So
melee
they needed something to give them a bit more physical damage into the later stages and more. I mean, it's a good lane with the Sniper versus a DK. DK always does pretty well.
Yeah.
But
It's interesting.
It is interesting.
It's
I think
interesting.
We're saying interesting again.
Interesting.
We're staying away from that. Get rid of it.
It's the cop-out word.
Yeah.
Well, that's I like to go for intriguing. That's my cop-out.
Same thing.
Okay.
All right. Well, it's interesting. It's intriguing. Whatever you want to call it. Our intriguing casting duo is ready as well. LD Winter, you feeling good about this one?
I'm feeling good. I'm not sure how Faceless is feeling, Winter. They're up against elimination here. We're live on the floor of the Wang Theatre in Boston. You gave a little gasp when you saw that last pick, and going into it, looking at the state of the draft, there weren't that many great options for Faceless. You were like, do they go Puck? Not so good against Dragon Knight, not really strong here right now. Do they go Storm? It feels a little greedy. You know, I brought up the OD, which would be good in the lane, but then doesn't doesn't give you that space creator later on, so they end up going sniper, and then you gasped. Why did you gasp, Winter?
I mean, sniper is very similar to the reason why I didn't really fancy the OD suggestion that you were telling me, because it means that tri-core is pretty greedy. They're going to heavily rely on the enchanters. I think if Nuts plays like what he did in the last game, they're not going to be able to get away with their greedy cores this game. He needs to be able to secure space, secure the lanes for especially the Centaur and the Sniper. He shouldn't prioritize helping the Luna.
Well, there were some harsh words from PPD on Twitter, but I mean, it's fair to say Nuts, he's not normally known for playing these types of jungle heroes, so...
He doesn't play jungle heroes.
Not really given any time to adapt or to practice, obviously.
Bottom lane.
They might find a first blood here. Could be big. XY gonna lift him. Hasn't skilled anything yet, so they need to chain stun. They get off the stomp. The follow-up shrapnel comes through. Moon just gonna accept his fate. Doesn't want to start with level 1 Surge and be unable to farm.
Well, this time,
so a first blood for Faceless. Something sorely needed for
this
them.
Time DC moves into the enemy jungle. The last game when Faceless had the Chen pickup, DC did not really invade and try to put wards to block off. This time, they change up their playstyle, so maybe expecting Faceless to, you know, run in the jungle, but instead Faceless went for the aggressive play with their smoke. The teams have been doing this more and more, because you see mostly the standard play would be to smoke up, get a ward. You know, that's the pretty much norm nowadays, but we see a couple of teams starting to switch around, trying for smoke, like 5-man smoke or 4-man smoke, trying to get first blood instead of using the smoke to just place a ward. You smoke, you get a kill, and you place the ward after. So, catching them off guard here.
So where do you want to see Nuts go on the Enchantress? He was the big focus of discussion in Game 1. Playing a slightly different jungler in the edge, but still similar fundamental concept for the laning stage. Do you go into the enemy woods? Do you want to pressure the offlane this time? What is the ideal play for him?
I think because the Centaur is on the safe lane, right now they're switching lanes. They do not want... I guess they don't want the Luna to go against Darkseer. Or they were trying to avoid the Juggernaut lane because they saw the Darkseer at bottom. Yeah, previously, Faceless saw the Darkseer bottom and they got the first blood, so they were kind of expecting Darkseer to be at bottom. They do not want a Luna to go against that lane, so right now, because he's in the Juggernaut's lane, this is not good for them. They need the Enchantress to help out.
She's trying to, as Nuts moves in, but Misery there can just easily arrow the creep.
Yeah,
kill it off, and
that's a great point.
That's a big issue for the Enchantress. If she goes where the Morana is, likely just gonna lose her creeps.
That is actually something that I totally forgot about, where because people don't pick Chen or Enchantress as much, but Morana is absolutely counter against that.
So you have to stay away from the Morana now, it feels like.
Black has to go top. Like, they need to move Black towards the safe lane. If the Enchantress can't really help out this lane at all, he needs to ditch. He needs to go top.
Yeah, he's a potential kill if he ever gets caught by a disruption. There won't be a good save.
He's going top now. And, oh, Ice! Wow!
Big solo kill there for Ice. And then the TP home, so nice fountain trip for him. Good timing for Black to rotate.
Oh my god, that is
huge.
Such a good transition by Daryl there on the Centaur. They knew they had to switch the lanes, but he went for the kill, trying to, you know, at least when they're switching a lane, get a kill. That's what you want to happen when you're switching lanes. You do not want to just switch lanes and move around, waste your TP.
Meanwhile, mid lane, Weeha getting pressure, but unfortunately jabs. He eats the arrow under tower.
Oh my god.
Misery with the drive-by. It would have been a likely kill on Weeha otherwise, but the savvy veteran in position. And now Weeha sticks around. He'll salve right up.
This is
and
what
the sniper goes down.
This is what you see from Misery a lot. He's always at the right place at the right time as a support. Like, that is one of his biggest traits as a support player. Always there when his team needs him.
And Winter, they don't have any wards to help him out here mid, unfortunately. Where generally against a Morana, against Spiritbreaker, we often see one if not two wards, especially for a squishier hero like the sniper. He doesn't have any vision to help him. So
Enchantress is all the way down right now, and Misery sees the creep. He's gonna try to arrow the creep. Gets the creep.
The problem is it's not that easy to juke with the creeps because they're relatively slow.
Well, if Enchantress has like two creeps, so he wouldn't mind too much about that.
Top lane, another takedown though. Moon getting punished here. That's some much needed experience to Black and XY.
This is really going bad for Moon on the Darkseer. He might want to go for the jungle camps.
Yeah, he did grab the early boots though. Not your ideal build if he wants to go.
Oh,
you see the can see Weeha didn't have a whole lot of vision work with the arrow comes through and
still
end up going down.
Still a very, very good move there by Misery, anticipating. Like, he's always around the jungle, so when he sees the enemy mid laner try to kill his mid laner, he moves in, gets an arrow. Just good anticipation, good movements around the map.
So Nuts, level 2.
He's going back to the bottom.
And a half. He's gonna come bottom again,
oh,
and look
no,
who's
Misery.
There. Hey, buddy. How you doing?
Oh no.
He doesn't even care about the end. She's just gonna eat the creep. Nuts is just feeding Misery straight up at this point. Already almost level 3.5, a full level up. And meanwhile, in the bottom lane, there's some pressure on Ice. The spin comes through.
He's fine.
From Resolution, he will survive, but he's getting bullied a little bit here. And there's a Soul Catcher ready.
I mean, Nuts really wants to avoid Misery at all costs. He wants to be able to gank the lane that the Mirana is not guarding at the moment. It's not ideal for the Enchantress.
If you could, though, there's a decent chance Mirana's going to be there, and I don't know if they need him top. Moonmander's been
relatively well in the lane. If he tries to make a move top, that's a better chance of them getting something done rather than, you know, moving to the Mirana's area. Right now, the mid lane and the bottom lane is Misery's territory. He's going to be always constantly making sure that the Enchantress doesn't create any sort of pressure on those two lanes.
Resolution continuing to...
Do they have a smoke?
A Rass Ice here.
They might bring the Rubik this time. Oh, that's a ward there. Alright, so
The struggle continues for poor Nuts.
They might be able to get a gank top though if they move to back towards top.
Not with that scan, I would think.
Look at Moon.
Staying far up, he really expects this gank to go on mid, and
I mean, that's the
Faceless
right.
Hesitating.
That's the right play for Faceless.
You can just see Misery just waiting for the gank.
Just sending his illusions, and he's just doing the right play as a 4-row support, playing against a Chen / Enchantress, a jungling hero that wants to gank. You should always anticipate his movement and try to break the smoke. Once again, there, brilliant play by DC, having that vision to set up the information that they needed. And moving the supports right away to, you know, break the smoke. Just good play all in all.
A little love tap there for XY as Ice will deny himself to the neutrals.
As his tranquils
now.
So at least he's going to be able to stay in the lane much better right now. But still, Juggernaut lane is not an easy lane for an offlaner to survive on. He has to be very careful with all the moves. Misery setting up. Trying to set up from behind to land an arrow. Weeha still not back in the lane, so probably has to wait for Weeha to walk himself back into lane. He does have his ultimate up.
Meanwhile, bottom lane, they are also prepping here with a disruption. Ice gonna tank the spin. Soul Catcher was committed. It will drop him low. Not enough for the kill, and now Resolution getting slightly blocked. Well, back away. Meanwhile, Misery, as you mentioned, is hounding Japs in the woods. Not particularly afraid. He is gonna run into Nuts. Nuts this time has a decent sized army. Troll trap to start. He's gonna leap up to the high ground. Assassinate coming through. And that will be enough for the kill. The pew pew does its work. And finally, they get something going against Misery.
Well, this time their laning phase has gone much, much better.
Bottom lane, Ice. He went for the stomp, but Resolution quick on the draw with
stick,
the Blade Fury.
Stick.
The stick, and doesn't matter. Resolution with the phase boots has that extra bit of damage. Finds the kill anyway. 4-2, but with that exchange killing off Misery, experience going much more favorably now for Faceless.
Well, at least compared to the last game, the laning phase has gone much better this time.
How do you see them transitioning? Because the one guy that really is looking to set the tempo here in the mid game is the Centaur. Ice, he did find the kill, but Winter, he's not farming very well. 13 CS, it's going to be a slow blink.
Yeah, that is definitely not good. Like, if you compare it to someone like, oh, Arrow, not going to land on XY there. He was trying to, you know, do support things, place a deep ward, but Misery there to foil his intentions. But Centaur definitely not like Slala. You don't have that sprint. I mean, you're going to have access to that Stampede, at least, at level 6, but he doesn't really set up a lot of kills like a Slala pre-blink, you know. Slala pre-blink still is able to get a lot of work done for your team. But right now, we see this again from DC. Remember the last game when Luna had his ultimate up, they made a smoke play, they made a rotation to pressure towers, and right now, this time on the Juggernaut Resolution, again, making the same movement towards the enemy side of the map. He doesn't just sit in his lane and farm, and he's always looking to use his spell, especially his Omni Slash right now. He wants to put it on cooldown.
Ice is chasing bottom. Sox already committed disruption. He has Stampede. He has no TP,
so if Jug comes here, he's going to be able to get the kill.
Oh, he has Stampede, but already Jug closing the gap has the Mango for the Omni Slash. He Stampedes out, Resolution, phase boots, and Ice continues to wind through the trees. Misery could cut him off, but XY's there, ready with the lift. They're going to be able to bring the Mirana down. That also saves Ice, who might have gotten clipped by an arrow on the way out.
Oh my god, that was...
good mirror movements.
That was actually such a good play by Ice, understanding how much time he exactly has before his supports arrive. One more second delay that he might have actually gone down to that Omni Slash plus Blade Fury.
Just able to get to the trees.
Yeah, he's just one of those few offlaners, you know. You interview all the carry players here at the event. Everyone will tell you they hate to play against Ice Slash offlane.
And he's not like that he is a fair, obviously he's a great offlaner, but he's like the kind that likes to push it to the limit, you know, see
the,
just how much
most
he can get.
Annoying offlaner, they would tell you.
Yeah, it, sometimes it doesn't work out, but you know, he's not like Universe where he plays it very safe generally. Daryl, much more of the aggressive, eke every little bit of farm and go for the kills where you can.
They are both very similar. DC's offlaner, Moon and Daryl.
Moon is much more similar.
A lot average deaths that compared to Universe, but they get a lot more done when they, you know, have a good game. So Black right now makes his
jabs and all the trouble. Here in the mid lane, disruption's gonna come through. Arrow. They can follow this up with the Weeha stun. They do have a breathe fire, and that soul catcher damage easily gets dealt with.
That arrow, he got blocked as well by the engines there, so he couldn't really run down towards the river, unable to juke off the arrow. And here comes again Ice trying to creep skip and allow Black to secure the tower for his team.
Ice very low in the bottom lane, really just begging Moon to come at him. It's like, guys, we can kill him, but he's got some backup. They're still pressuring mid though. Double damage rune was up on Weeha for that first kill. A sniper, and now they're going to take the tower as well.
No, this is really good for DC.
It's actually a double tower grab. They also get top.
They move so quickly once they saw Black, because they had a lane ward. They saw Black TPing to the bottom lane, so immediately they move resolution towards the top lane. They did not want to take that fight. They managed to use the DK in the mid lane to secure the tower as well. So once again, DC's short calling, amazing.
All three of their cores farming well. Nuts has not had the explosive impact. They're losing the tower war early, despite a great individual effort by Ice to find the solo kill. DC have just weathered that storm, and they're now back out in front. Down kills, but up gold, up experience. Feeling very comfortable going into the mid-game. And so, looking towards that mid-game winter, how do you feel the teams will match up here?
If Centaur doesn't get a timely blink, I think Faceless will struggle. But if Centaur gets a good blink, I think it's going to come down to who makes the first move, who gets the better initiation, who gets the jump.
Did stop off for the Iron Talon, has the point in return now.
Well, the other thing we might actually see in a crucial part in teamfights is Darkseer is going to be able to build the mech on his team, whereas for Faceless, the center, obviously, you can't get the mech for your team. So that might be a difference maker in the mid-game, having a mech and against a team who does not have a mech.
Well, Moon playing very cautiously here bottom. Ice. Was thinking about a flank, but it's some time not spending farming towards that blink. He'll back off to the jungle now, hanging around, but... Again, he's not hitting creeps.
DC is also saving up a lot of gold on Dragonite, so Weeha might consider an early dagger as well. That will give them a lot of initiative.
Oxa, he's in position here to set up an Ice. They're going to disrupt instantly. Starfall comes through, but not timed correctly. The arrow hitting the creep, and then he's going to stampede. He wants to run forward. Stomp is there, has the double edge. Ice playing very aggressively. But this might give DC round two.
Taunting them as
well. Just toying with his food.
I mean, there was no way they got that kill after the Starstorm actually on Misery. Maybe a bit of a miscommunication there from the two supports. But regardless, that was an opportunity miss for DC. But overall, they're still playing really well. You see what Resolution is doing here on the enemy safe lane. Like, because Juggernaut has that innate survivability with the spin TP, you can actually do this. But the Luna can't really push the lane, you know, far out. You have to take the safer routes to farm. So. What Resolution is doing right now, he's not only farming, but he's also creating a lot of room for the rest of his team to, you know, to farm.
And they're taking advantage of it on the bottom lane. And now a blink is grabbed by Weeha.
This is going to be very, very crucial for their initiation, because Darkseer does not want to get an early dagger. You want to get a mech on Darkseer. So with the mech coming online, he's very, very close to completing that and being having that dagger on Weeha. So it's going to give DC a lot of... good team fight right now with the mech plus blink coming online.
Tower down, and without a blink on Ice, how do you fight into this winter?
How close is he to the dagger? Well, he's
not very close.
Oh, this is not good for them.
He's been spending a lot of time just sitting in the jungle, like threatening for ganks.
I mean, you kind of
backing up his Luna, but as a result, not farming.
You kind of have to hope for Rubick to start the fight, I guess, with the telekinesis. But that's not reliable at all, you know. That's not what you want. You want the Centaur to go in, make a first move, so Rubick has time to stay back. Decide on what spell you want to steal and go in for the lift after. So things are not looking too good without the dagger right now for Faceless. They desperately need the dagger on Daryl here. They need to get that ASAP, whereas the rest of the items on the Sniper and Luna is not going to make such a huge difference right now for them.
Well, if they can find the dagger, find some kills. They do have decent push behind it from the Luna, the edge creeps.
Whereas for T, look at them, they're just ready to make moves right now. They're very active around the map because they don't feel the need to, you know, to wait for any item. They already have the dagger plus mech.
XY gets the cheeky spin. Little steal.
Right now, everything is online for DC. They have the dagger. And, oh, the mech is still in the base, so wouldn't have that for the fight. But once again, DC are a team that understands their timings very well, their windows very well. They understand that the enemy is waiting on the Santos dagger. They're not ready to fight, so we are going to take the fight to them.
Are they going to try to make a move on resolution? If they could get off a lift here, going to at least bully him back.
It's going to be difficult for the Rubik to lift the Juggernaut, to be honest.
Like, especially when there's a ward in the area, so he knows, he'll back away. And
just look at resolution again. He knows that the team is able to, you know, farm powers, and he's just making sure that he's farming efficiently around the map, and he's trying to get the kill
ice,
up
ice, 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 into the trees. Oh. He's hunting, Stop comes out, he baits resolution, now tries to survive. No, he runs back into the Blade Fury! Ice, 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 getting too cute.
Okay,
And will be punished.
That is one moment that you wish that he wasn't that aggressive, like Universe.
And
whatever,
he was
like,
so close. He was so close to his blink. Now he's down to 1500 gold.
He was trying to basically bait the Juggernaut to try and kill him, so his team could have came in for the return kill. But TP reactions here from Faceless, but without the Centaur, they kind of don't have really good ways of initiating the fight. That was a very, very big loss for Daryl. You see what he was trying to do, trying to get as much as he can from the position, but ultimately paying a very, very heavy price, losing that timing on the blink.
And they don't have a Dragonite midwinter. They don't have a hero that can take over in the tempo control role. Sniper is not going to be starting the fights, and if he does, he's probably dying.
But on the bright side of things, Sniper and Luna does offer your team a whole lot amount of like big physical plus spell damage in team fights if you can actually get a proper initiation. And if you look at DC, I don't think they have as much damage in terms of their tool cost, but they do have an offlaner Darkseer, which the longer the game progresses, he's going to get better illusions of your heroes. But right now the Sniper and Luna are going to be able to do a good amount of damage if Faceless are able to get a first move on. But Misery here going to scout out XY.
XY is Blade Fury though, very tough to kill. Yeah, Rubik, if he has quick reactions against the arrow.
One of the best spells he had this game, apart from like the Omni, like even the vacuum or the spin would be nice for the Rubik here. But as of right now,
Disruption always great.
Yeah, as of right now, Faceless are just desperately waiting for ISSI to get his dagger. He's very close now, but DC looking to pressure and looking to use this time where Centaur does not have blink.
And what do you know? Another DD rune for Weeha. He's got the Elder Dragon form ready. DC ramping back on towards mid, they might try to go for the lower hanging fruit here, the tier 2.
Yeah, their lanes, they need to take care of their lanes. Their lanes are not looking good. All of their lanes are pushing.
And they don't have Moon, so going high ground without your mech bearer, big team fight specialist, not ideal.
Yep, this game you probably want the Darkseer to get all the team fight, survivability items. You get the pipe, even the Crimson Guard would be a good choice here against the Sniper. All those items would negate a majority of the damage coming up from Faceless since they have the blink on the Dragonite. The Dark is not
right.
So needed.
Is this
going to
be the big blink reveal? Ice 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 smoked up.
Can he get a big jump? Stomp?
But he's got to find ideally Soxa or at least multiple heroes. There's the stop to start with the disruption. Counter initiate. Now the Omni Slash dragging resolution back as they retreat out. XY already used the spell, so he does have his own disruption available.
Oh,
the eclipse from Black committed earlier. They get the Dragonite kill. Now they look for the turn. Try to bring down resolution. Very low. Will end up falling to the imp. Mooniander a bit late to the party, so it ends up being a 2-for-3 exchange. And they do have a stolen disruption. It's gonna be a 2-for-4 nuts. Just left alone in that fight. The Stampede dragging Juggernaut very far away from his team. And it didn't look like the best initiation as the disruption did counter that stomp, but Faceless still able to come out on top.
Well, like I said, it didn't really matter so much because they had a lot of damage. Luna and Sniper were dealing insane amount of damage at the back lines, even though the stun was sort of negated by the disrupt, but they still had enough in the tank. And not to mention Enchantress, she was dealing a huge part of the damage with in the team fights. So all those things considered, even if you lose the Centaur, as long as he gets the stun, he gets stunned, he forces the fight to happen.
And they focus him instead of going for the Sniper
or the
Luna.
The other heroes would just lay down,
or the Enchantress,
lay down the damage onto them. And the other crucial part about DC's teamfight is still missing. Darkseer does not have any points in the wall yet, and he does not have his max points in the vacuum, so they have to give Moonmander some time to, you know, get his levels. It's extremely crucial as an offlaner when you're Darkseer to get those levels on your spells.
Well, Faceless do have a small little ancient stack here, XY. Such a disruption available.
Small little ancient stacks. Like, two stacks. Not that small. But you wish you had more, you know, as the Luna. But
you always want more, and now they're gonna have an army of illusions if they want it.
You're the carry player, you know. Stack for me, guys. I mean, they're playing the Luna, you always tell your
team. Would you prefer a carry player who doesn't want to farm stacks?
No, of course not, you know. But I prefer, you know, you leave the stacks to me if I'm the Tidehunter.
Well, it's not playing that more greedy farming offlaner. He is just constantly...
You say that, but as the Centaur, you want to get to your eggs, you know? You really want to get to your eggs.
Well, it's actually something you brought up in the draft, Winter, and since we have a little lull here, I'd love for you to expand more on it, that... Nowadays, you feel like teams are drafting more for the items that heroes can build and less like for the hero abilities in a vacuum.
Yeah, sometimes you pick the hero not because the hero is extremely good. Like, for example, in this game, Slada would have offered up more in the early game, but the reason that they picked the Centaur is because you have that Aghanim's build out on the Centaur to negate the Juggernaut damage, the double Star Storm if the Mirana gets to the Axe, timing. It's just a very good build-up for the hero, so I think sometimes teams tend to value that a lot. That hero has a very good build-up against what the enemy composition has, instead of, oh, that hero is going to do well in certain parts of the game.
But it's a big item. It's not that easy to farm if you're constantly hiding in the trees and going for pickoffs.
Yes, Iron Tail, you know, that's...
But he hasn't been using it. Like, he has been, but it's mostly to eat trees and worm his way, you know, kind of through them to find pickoffs.
It still, it gives you that ability to, you know, get to that Aghs point. Some offlaners, I think, would get a Midas on, like, for example, a Slada or Clockwork. You see a lot of Midas on those offlaners or a Nyx to catch up. But for Centaur, I think, I've not seen anyone get a Midas, but Iron Talon is a good way of getting to it. You want to get to your Aghanim into it. It's really, really crucial. Just like a Nyx Ag, it's game-changing.
DC made a move here into the Dire Jungle. Not having that overwhelming advantage they did in game number one, though. It's a slight lead for them.
They have the dagger plus the wall on the Darkseer now, so they have all their tools for the team play.
And they do have the ability to seed with disruption illusions. Also, the Manta picked up on resolution and 2100 gold in the bank, so they'll pack down that tier two. Second to last outer tower brought down. Still five left standing for DC. Very healthy outer periphery of buildings here.
But teamfight-wise, they still have to be very careful about the Luna and the Sniper. They need a gap close. They need someone to, you know, get to the back lines, kill the Sniper especially. He's just outputting so much damage. So
they do have Surge into Blink Stun.
I like Dagger though, Resolution. Like,
and you also have Moonlight Shadow now, and Faceless, no gem, only a single pack of dust on XY.
Oh, talk about Midas.
Alright.
Misery, I think he's one of the supports that mixes the Midas a lot, especially on his CMs, on a lot of his supports.
Well, he popularized Midas gaming way back in, I think it was LGD National, right?
Oh, back when you were younger, Gorman. Back when you were younger.
Hey, are you calling me old?
You're more mature now.
You're the married man.
But going by numbers, you're still the older man, sorry.
But I'm young at heart.
Fine, whatever.
You're a crabby old man at heart.
For DC right now, they're still looking to, you know, force fights. They feel like they're more ready with the dagger pickup on resolution. They have the accessory tools to, you know, get to that backline, get the Omni Slash onto the Sniper. That's what you want as the Juggernaut this game. You want to kill him right away before the Sniper lays down too much damage in the team fights. Whereas you leave the rest for the Darkseer and the Dragon Knight to take care.
And look at the way they're sieging. They put resolution in front, has the Shadow Demon parked behind him in the trees. With the Manta, the Blink, and the Shadow Demon, it is very tough to jump this jug.
At the same time, they want to set up for a top defense as well. Misery TP's himself back to its top lane. You see their movements, they are always very, very good at...
Even scanning ahead, they are just so ready for that counter push.
They take a tower, they defend their own tower, and they have a hero always ready, you know, set up a fight.
Could they find resolution here? They do have vision of him, but Weeha's right in the neighborhood.
Moonlight
Shadow, Ice, in position on the high ground. But
they want to fight this. They see Misery at top previously.
They have a sentry. They're going to plant it and just hope that DC comes in range. There's a sentry from both
Faceless
avenues.
Has the numbers here.
Jabs could get caught, though. There's the stomp to start. They do get Weeha. Initiation is there. The disruption comes through a bit too late, though. It looks like should be going down. One more plink for Mr. Ho-Ho-Ha-Ha. He will fall.
Yep. DC was
push
not,
over, folks.
DC were not ready for that. They did not know that Faceless have the vision there. So Faceless, with the numbers advantage, were able to overpower DC in that fight. I mean, nevertheless, DC is still in pretty good shape getting all the towers. But...
into the pit.
Can they defend this? They have a vision here, so they see FL going into the Rosh pit.
Resolution.
They don't have enough heroes. They don't have enough heroes here. Misery TP'd back to base. With the Dragonite down, there's only three heroes here.
But Faceless are scared. They don't want to go in.
They don't have the quickest Rosh lineup to right now. They don't have minus armor.
Yeah, they can do it safely with the Enchantress to tank. Level 4 untouchable.
Yeah, but
as you mentioned,
it's
slow. It's
gonna take a long time, so...
Instead, they will smoke.
Can they get a pick off your... A good pick off would be like on someone like the Darkseer, your team fight specialist. If you're able to remove that, then you can maybe go for the Rosh.
The line is drawn. They're going to swing around on Sansa. Actually, still pretty big. There's the stop. Double edge follow up. They get the kill. Steal the level on Shadow Poison.
Rubik was dying to get disruption.
Sad XY.
Gosh, I mean, it's good to have a point on Poison. You know, a lot of players right now, they go for the max Soul Catcher and Disrupt. And yeah. Against a Rubik, you want to have a point.
It used to be like the max Shadow Poison would be the dream spell
to
steal.
This game, you want
to
have a point in Poison so that Rubik doesn't get that easy steal. I mean, it's a big deal, you know, this game. Damn Luna.
We're going to see a pretty early gem grab by Misery. No, Midas already.
I mean, that's a
able to
that's
fuel
like
that
a,
purchase.
That's like a good reaction as a captain. You the last minute or so, you feel like something is wrong. Why are our moves not working? It's either they anticipated our moves or they see us, so he gets a jam right away after that. He wants to deward. That's just something a captain would do. Guys, I'm gonna get a jam. Make sure that they don't do that anymore.
And the beautiful thing is, he can easily afford it.
Dude, he was right. There was a ward there when they smoked, so he was actually right about that.
And DC. Now the Greaves up a Moon Meander, Blink as well. Oh, we saw that picked up earlier. So they do continue to farm Winter, even though it feels like Faceless getting a little bit more of their footing. They are down on net worth, they're only slightly ahead in experience. Big item still coming out for Digital Chaos, BKB nearly complete for Weeha. We could see Miz transition back into the Ags as the game gets a bit later, and then of course, Resolution farming very well.
With
Manta, Blink, already complete, and now a Maelstrom too.
Talking about Ags, you know, Faceless have three great heroes to get Ags on. So it's not only DC that has the Ags build on their heroes.
Are they going to farm them is the question.
Well, he's trying, dude. He's halfway there. He has a point booster and has 1,000 gold. Come on. He's going to try his very best to get there. He's going to have a big part to play in the
sometimes
game.
Sometimes, Winter, your very best is not good enough.
Yeah, sometimes, but you're still, you know, you're still going to try. You're going to try to get that point. And you have Sniper plus Luna. You have very good defense on the high ground. And you have Rubik to spam out the waves. So.
What is that old saying? A wise creature once said, do or do not, no try. There is no try.
But if you don't try, you have already failed. So you must always try first.
All right, well, DC, they're certainly trying now. An aggressive smoke forward. Resolution.
They're always like looking to fight right now, whereas for Faceless, they are much more contented because of their composition. They have a very, very good composition for late game, so they are happy. And you have Black on the team. He's always going to be comfortable, you know, trying to farm and get more items, not wanting to fight so much. So for DC, they are just trying to control the map more, they have the gem, so they're moving around with Mirana to make sure that they deward all the vision.
Uh-oh. The black mid, but there is a big trap being laid here with XY in reserve behind him, the whole team in the neighborhood.
Oh, the ward is gonna see Moon. He's gonna know now.
We'll back away, had the invis rune.
He's gonna tell, hey, gem carrier, come over, there's a sentry.
They're gonna back off.
Right now,
hey, it's time for Ice Ice Ice. Suddenly another 1,000 gold. All right, starting to get closer to the eggs.
I told you to believe him. He's gonna get his eggs this game.
You're biased.
Oh, fine. He's gonna get his eggs this game. And there's one last.
You're like willing him into the eggs. Now to be fair, it is one of the very strongest eggs in the game if used properly, with the insane damage reduction.
I think Omni Slash and the double Star Storm from Mirana when she has Ags. They're gonna use Moonlight, try to find a move here. Is there a sentry in the lane? That is the question. There is.
They've been so disciplined. Oh, they have one on the hill. DC trying to go for a bit of a D ward. They're gonna blink in, initiate the fight. It's on the Rubik. BKB committed. The Golden Dragon brings them down, and now they chase forward looking for more. Mm-hmm. It's only a Rubik. They committed a 10-second BKB for that solitary kill.
To be fair, Gorman, that was actually worth it for Faceless losing the support for that BKB. Heavy charge. They are not going to be able to pressure because the bottom lane is pushed out. And top lane is pushed out as well. DC needs to take
tier 1. Will they finally get it? The triple rage creep just slowly plinking away at the structures here.
They're going for the Rosh here though. Let's see if Faceless decides.
But without the BKB, would they consider a fight? No, Moon has great position here to break a smoke.
Faceless is not moving the Luna over to fight though. It seems like they are not.
They're thinking about it. Ice coming in, Jap's coming in. And Moon.
Luna's not dead,
looking
though.
For the intel. And Resolution's gonna jump. There's the quick initiation. Omni coming through. And in a hail of destruction, DC slaughter them.
What is
Faceless
going
are
on?
Not on the same page, and that was a huge gimme.
What is going on there with the team? Like, they were on the page for sure, and another pickup here because...
Just like that. Just three free kills.
Gosh.
Just... absolutely avoidable.
It seems like the two players, the sniper and the centaur, were like wanting to fight the Roche, but Black didn't seem interested to take that fight. Now they're gonna force a buyback onto jabs on the sniper. That is very, very detrimental to their item
progression. And they even buy back on jabs to hold the tower. That is extremely
look at
painful.
Moonlander.
Yeah, really good position. Even if they did try to smoke, he would have been able to break it. The arrow comes in. Then they're like, eh, should we go in? Should we not? They're still hesitating. You can see Ice just milling back and forth.
You know why he was hesitating? His carry was not making his move away over to the rush pit. Yeah, that's why he was hesitating.
You got to imagine either there wasn't enough talking or there was too much disagreement in the war room there for Faceless.
Either way, that is not a good sign at all. But when you make a decision, you have to be quick. It's either you go in and die together or you don't go in at all. But they were split up, they got caught, and that was really not a good showing from Faceless. And the Aghanim's crucial item on Centaur is going to be delayed once again because of that death. And right now, Resolution on the Juggernaut more than ready to take the high ground here with all his items completed. The Mjolnir, the Dagger, the Manta. They want to get the lanes push out and siege the base. That's what DC wants right now. They have already removed almost all the wards from the Faceless map. No vision means very difficult to split push for them. And they're going to be forced to defend with the Shrapnel.
Oh, now Black wants to fight.
He has his BKB.
As the BKB is going to scout out Moonmander here. Trying to harass him a bit with the glaze, but there will be the Greaves retreat. If he had eclipsed immediately, maybe could have gotten the kill, but
still, you know, it's
a risk.
It's very iffy there. He did not have any, you know, setup from the Centaur or the Rubik. So you do not want to blow a big cooldown on something that's uncertain. But right now, DC, they're just trying to get their lanes pushed out, and Darkseer is, he's going to move to his team right now. So they're going to siege the high ground.
DC, while Faceless hesitate, they're decisive. Resolution moves on to top, has the Aegis, completed Mjolnir, hacking away at the tower, quickly bringing it low. They're going to lift him. And then try to chip at him. Jabs not going to rev up the assassinate. Go for the stomp. Solution ready with the Blade Fury. Could have been an easy Aegis pop otherwise.
Yep, you don't really want to waste the Aegis. Like you want to, you know, force the enemy to use a big cooldown on you and you die. But you don't want to give away like a kill with like,
such a safe siege for DC though. They've got the Jug out in front and again the positioning. Look at Soxa so far back.
He can always spin and hit the power.
And he has Aegis and he has Manta. Lots of escape plans for Resolution who is about to bring this tower down. Is starting to drop a bit to the Imps. Decent damage done. Assassinate with the Fade Bolt. No, the disruption. No siree, they say, and now the Stampede committed. They're going to try to jump on a Weehawk. He'll be available, but he gets lifted. Good control here. DC unable to get the finish. Faceless Ars. Weehawk survives with the Beaky. Black going to commit the Eclipse, but his own illusion being turned against him. Nearly dead to that as Weehawk surges in. Can't quite get in range. Has to back away, and they look for the chase.
Omni.
They're so low.
Rubik has Omni.
They could make big plays here. The impetus damage. There's the surge. Can they get in range? Arrow. Could set door. Ice. With the stop. Set up on the moon. Can they finish the job? Not quite yet. And oh, that's not enough for now. DC able to stagger the retreat, walk away safely. Great communication. Where Faceless feel like they're not on the same page. DC feel like it's one player controlling all five heroes at times. Just so coordinated. Blink stun, arrow follow, backs there as well. Then the disrupt. They're going to prep for round two. This gives the Dragon Tail a chance to cool down. Black all the way back to the well. Does even make it. Resolution diving him into the fountain. Slaughtering the cat therein.
That's got to be
their
last straw.
And that's Elaine of Rax.
That's got to be their last straw there for Faceless.
And this looks like the end, Winter. It's going to be an early exit for them from the Boston Major, unless a miracle can pop out.
That was their last straw. They used two of their buybacks there, and right now, no buybacks remaining. Faceless, you know, gonna struggle.
Still no centaur eggs, no big items to turn this one around. Few buildings remain, digital chaos. Contrary to the name, looking like a unified squad here. And
Faceless are the ones that look chaotic this game.
And not good chaotic either. This is indecisive chaotic. You know, it's like when MVP was at their best, they would play chaotically, but it was organized chaos. They would run at you, they would force your team into disarray, and they would punish. You know, looking back to like the Manila Major, the Shanghai Major, not the case here for Faceless. Mega creeps now. The end is nigh. They can wait, but we'll be going home.
Ice just casually farming the enemy jungle.
few last moments here on the stage for him.
Want to get my eggs.
You know, Black did say in that recent interview he did that he doesn't expect them to disband even with an early exit here, but that's often said. We'll have to see if that's how it turns out. Weehaw just trying to force them out of the game, diving them extremely far towards the fountain. And last stand, they want to loosen beam. Moomian are not going to allow it. He gets up the back of the wall as well. Up on the high ground, he will fall. They do even find that Dragonite kill. DC, like, all right, well, if you want to play that game, we will just let the creeps kill you.
It was still a heavy price to pay, you know, for that 3 kills, losing your whole base. So, okay. Mega creep defense, what do they have? They have Luna.
They have Luna, one of the better heroes against Megas.
They have Return on Centaur. Oh, Arrow.
All right, 80-minute comeback. Here we come.
So, against Mega creeps, you want to have a Vlad, you want to have a... I think what the strat MEP did against the Mega Creep was they had multiple Helm of Dominators and they dominated the army and they surrounded the troll with the army. That's how they held. So those are the ways where you can defend against a Mega Creep and get Maelstrom. They already have a Maelstrom on. Sniper, other heroes, not exactly good candidates for that.
If you're DC, you're just saying, we're not letting them farm all these items and take it 80 minutes. We're just going to run down mid. You can see the line drawn immediately by Moon. Probably a little baffled that they're still sticking around, but he is going to try and end this one ASAP.
I mean, it's their last game, so they're going to defend to the bitter end.
There is a stolen wall on the Rubik right now, level 2, XY. Could be a big pickup. Most importantly, the Centaur Axe is online. That is... as strong as it is, the timing on the Stampede has to be right. Oh. And it's also their most important way to
the Omni Slash, I think.
Initiate.
He needs to time it with the Omni Slash.
That would be the ideal scenario. DC marching out mid. Could wait for that next Roche if they really want to slow roll it. But they're going to finish off the buffer buildings here. Just a few huts remain in the shambles that is the Faceless base. They can chip illusions. The glaives start to ramp up. Luna being turned against Faceless now. And Misery just fencing around. Has the eggs, has the blink. So they've got a fourth core coming online should this go later. Well out farming Ice at this point. And creeps continue to march in. At some point, Faces are going to have to make their move. Buildings being brought low, finished off resolution. One tier 4 down, one to go. And Misery just plink, plink, plink. Low but sure progress being done as Weeha finds the opening and straight on to Ice back wall. And destruction ensues. Jabs and Black both in danger. Mauled into submission as DC ended. A final dagger into the heart of Faceless fans everywhere. It will be an early exit from them, and I'll have to go back to the drawing board for their next event.
Maybe be on the same page for the next event as well. There were clearly many bad decisions made by Faceless. They weren't on the same page as a team, whereas DC were clearly, you know, having the third shot calling, very clear about what they wanted to do and when they wanted to do it and who was going to move.